the National Wrestling Alliance.
Hello again, everybody, and welcome to World Championship Wrestling. Jim Ross and Magnum TA coming to you from the studios of Superstation TBS. And it's certainly my pleasure and my privilege to be working with a legend in his own time, Magnum TA. Magnum, welcome to World Championship Wrestling.
Jim Ross, it's a pleasure to be here. You know, I grew up watching this very prestigious wrestle myself every Saturday night. This was the place to be, and I'm glad to be here so close to the action once more.
I'll tell you something, this is the night to be here because, fans, you're going to see a great six-man tag team combination, the Junkyard Dog, Michael Hayes, and Sting in competition. That rowdy Texan from Waxahachie, Dick Murdoch, will be here with us, along with the Road Warriors, Hacksaw Butch Reed, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, in that big public workout. I find that most interesting. Plus, Abdul the Butcher will be here, the Wyndhams in tag team action, and so much more. You know, Magnum, it takes a lot of courage to be a professional wrestler, and I know you know a great deal about courage. So does this young man right here that's joining us, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, who was involved in a very tragic situation here last week. Yeah. I want to thank you for being here. It takes a lot of guts to walk out here in your condition. But fans, before we talk to Eddie, let's go back in time 7 days and see what happened right here in the studio. Steamboat basically helpless right now. Eddie Gilbert has come in. Eddie Gilbert coming to the aid of his partner. But now, Blair. Oh, and it's Grant Gilbert face first into the post. Teddy Long went for a ride all the way over here.
Steamboat is down. He cannot help Eddie at all. And Eddie's the one that desperately needs some help right now.
Well, is he face first on the floor here? Blair with a knee right to the back of the head. His face. I know you got a lot to say, Eddie.
Well, Jim, I came back to the NWA to try to be a nice guy. I want to tell Ric Flair, Barry Windham, whoever's listening, turn up the volume right now. If you wanted to get rid of Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert or Ricky Steamboat, you should have dug a big, deep grave and piled of dirt on top of me. Because you break my arm, I'm coming back. You break my neck, I'll be back. You broke my nose, brother. You two better hope, because this morning, Ric Flair, I heard you say that you and Barry Windham are the two hottest commodities in professional wrestling. Well, I couldn't agree with you anymore, because when I get finished with you, you're both going to be well done. Get my drift, Jim Ross. They better pray they make it to February 20th, Chi-Town Rumble.
All right, Hot Stuff Eddie Gilbert, ladies and gentlemen. Now let's go back up to the ring. The Varsity Club will be in tag team action. Kevin Sullivan and Dr. Death Steve Williams. And fans, we mentioned that next Saturday morning here on the Superstation, Dr. Death, Kevin Sullivan, and Mike Rotunda will meet Paul Ellering, Road Warrior Animal, and Road Warrior Hawk in a six-man tag team event. And Magnum, these are the United States Tag Team Champions, and indeed, especially Dr. Death Steve Williams, they are an awesome wrestling machine.
These men are definitely a force to be reckoned with. You know, you can say what you like about their styles, but these men do a lot of damage.
Dr. Death Steve Williams, single leg pickup. Of course, fans in Cleveland, Ohio, that big event coming on February the 15th. Dr. Death and Kevin Sullivan will defend their United States Tag Team Championships against an outstanding team, the former two-time U.S. Tag Team Champions, the Fantastics, in a big rematch. But right here is George South and Bob Emery, and George South is in a very precarious position as Sullivan is working on the leg.
You know, Jim, you could say very safely that Kevin Sullivan is probably the most vicious man in professional wrestling. He's not the biggest, he's not the strongest, but this man goes at you with an adversity. He really messes your day up. He doesn't care how he does it, but he really leads his team into some serious situations.
Sullivan at 255 pounds, and Dr. Death goes about 295. There's a half Boston crab there, and he's really exerting the pressure on George South. And Williams has always had that mean streak. Magnum, you were around this man in the old Mid-South when he first got into the sport. He's always been one bad apple. And Kevin Sullivan, I think you very aptly described him. He's the Jim Jones of the Guyana tragedy. The Jim Jones of professional wrestling is Kevin Sullivan, one sick human being.
Well, absolutely. You know, Steve, Dr. Death Williams doesn't need a whole lot of encouragement. And as you said, this man zeroes right in. Vicious kick to the hamstring. This man knows how to get the job done. He's hurting his opponent. He isn't trying to beat him. He's hurting him.
Snap Mayer and Bob Emery tags in. Dr. Death buries the knee right to the midsection of Dr. Death, opening up on a game, but perhaps out man. Oh, look at the strength here. This is a strong man.
That's right. You know, that isn't like pressing weights in a gym. That's dead weight he's got over his head, and he's throwing him around like he's a sack of potatoes.
Kevin Sullivan said, this is one death they ain't going to snack on. That's a quote, and I'm sure, obviously, he is speaking of the Road Warriors. And I want to tell you something. How do you think Dr. Death's going to match up strength-wise with a man like Road Warrior Animal, Magnum?
You know, I had the opportunity years ago to train with Steve Williams, and this man isn't a man that concerns himself with poundages. He concerns himself with what kind of poundages he can throw around in the ring. So in terms of strength against strength, I think Dr. Death Williams, can hold his best with Animal or anybody else in this sport.
Of course, Road Warrior Animal, a 600-pound bench presser, and Road Warrior Hawk, obviously no weakling. He benches well over 500 pounds. Kevin Sullivan, he doesn't push anything around but human beings, 255 pounds. He is a great athlete, but he is so deranged. I think he has one of the highest thresholds of pain of any athlete in the NWA. He likes pain, and look at the way he's working on that. That's a terrible wrist lock there.
Well, you're not going to make a Kevin Sullivan submit. You're not going to pin him on 1, 2, 3. You're going to have to knock this man completely out. In order for this man to lose, he's going to have to lose consciousness.
Dr. Death jerking on the arm of Bob Emery. As we mentioned, fans, if you just joined us, our big man event on Championship Wrestling next Saturday morning here on the Superstation will be the Varsity Club versus the Road Warriors and Paul Ellering. Dr. Death, they've got a plan of attack. They're trying to dissect, physically dissect Bob Emery and obviously incapacitate his arm.
Well, you know, these guys are two big bullies, but they got a game plan here. I mean, they're going right back to that one body part, and they're dishing out, I mean, a terrible amount of punishment. I don't know how long this guy's going to be able to stand up under this kind of attack.
Well, Emery trying to mount some offense. That's like hitting a giant redwood. Williams with a clubbing right hand, and down goes Bob Emery. George South showing a lot of guts, just wanting to tag in there.
Well, Emery's been seriously weakened right here. He's obviously hurt, and he desperately needs to get out of the ring if they're going to have any chance in this match at all.
Sullivan stomping away. This is a mark of an experienced athlete. They have singled out the arm of Bob Emery, and they want to break it. I think that's quite obvious, and I don't think that's an overstatement whatsoever.
Absolutely, and watch the way they're cutting the ring off there on the opponents. I mean, they're definitely confining them to one area here.
Man, they talk about a volatile nature. I tell you what, fans, the intensity of the NWA, this program and the NWA in general and more specifically are where you will find the athletes in professional wrestling. The greatest athletes in the world today are competing right now in the NWA, and over 25 of them will be in Philadelphia tonight for an awesome event starting at 8 o'clock. Dr. Death comes off the second rope, and Bob Emery is in as helpless a state as I have ever seen this fine young athlete.
You almost have to wonder what's holding this young man's arm on here, because Steve Williams is staying in the optimum position, keeping that leverage on the shoulder. Here, throwing that big tree trunk of a leg right over his shoulder. I mean, this guy is using all his force to his best ability.
Dr. Death didn't lose many matches in college. He was a four-time NCAA All-American. And I don't know of any fights he's ever lost in a bar room environment, and I think if we look to the Road Warriors track record, you can't find any losses with them in that environment. It's going to be like, I think you had definitely mentioned one time, it was the immovable force and the irresistible object or something along those lines. I think that's indeed what we'll have with the Varsity Club and the Warriors.
Well, I've never seen anybody that can make the Warriors run from any tight situation, but I think if these two men get themselves geared up enough, we're going to see the ultimate confrontation.
Look at Sullivan. Really, he's got it wrenched in really deeply. All his weight on Bob Emery. He's got the arm bit. Look at the angle, and that's it. Teddy Long, the referee. Emery has submitted here. And Sullivan and Williams, Dr. Depp, shoving George South around. Sullivan doesn't want to give it up. The sadistic Kevin Sullivan, as he and Dr. Death have tried to literally break the arm of Bob Emery here, forcing this youngster to submit. They get their hands raised in victory. And we'll go back, Magnum, and take a very quick look at the closing moments of this contest and a physical submission-type maneuver.
Jim, notice the intensity of Kevin Sullivan, the attack on this arm. He's narrowed in on his goal right here. He's going for it. He gets the...